Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Please come on in and find a seat. Our service is about to begin. We are overjoyed to be here together as Sophie is about to become a bat mitzvah. And she's sitting right here. She looks so beautiful in pink. And she's going to give us a big smile. And we're all going to say a huge mazel tov. You ready? One, two, three. Mazel tov. That was pretty good. Mazel tov right now means good luck. And the truth is, she doesn't really need luck because she knows her prayers so well. She's been working so hard to reach this day and to be able to be here to lead you. Unfortunately, her voice is a little hoarse today. And so we're going to be singing a lot of the prayers together with her. I want you to know that is no reflection on her ability because she knows every word, every single word. But we're going to ask her to keep, like, save her voice for her speech and her Torah reading. So we really want you to sing with us, too. Every chance you get, we want you to sing with us, with Sophie, with us, with me. I'm Rabbi Siegel, with Cantor Siegel as well. Gabby Enser-Tangier, we have Rabbi Sivan, who is visiting us from Israel to learn about Reform Judaism here in the United States, and also so that we can learn from her about Reform Judaism in Israel. And we have our wonderful accompanist on the piano, Jenny Snyder. And so we're all going to be singing. We want you to sing with us too. Now, first things first, if you have a cell phone, and I bet you do, please take it out and make sure that it is not going to ding, ring, have an alarm, buzz, or make any sound that's going to distract us for the next little while. So please, 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 I beg of you to please be sure that we can have a few moments of quiet, of peace, of not being distracted, and especially our teenagers, I know it's hard, but put them away, like really away for the next little while so that we can really be together in these moments of prayer. Because after all, a bat mitzvah is not a performance. It's a time that we can be together and pray and think about things that are important in our lives. So with all of that being said, we're going to have a nigun, a song with our cantor. A nigun is a wordless melody. So you don't need to know any words. You don't need a book right now. You will soon. But for right now, just sing with us. And we're in the moments, in these moments of Shabbat. It's getting to the end of Shabbat, when we want to just be in the moment and rejoice in this opportunity to be together. To call forward Sophie and her parents, Matilda and Ross, to give Sophie her talit, which she'll wear for the first time, her prayer shawl, and say a blessing for her.
Our hearts are one on this joyous day as you commit yourself to a life of Torah, a life, we pray, filled with wisdom, caring, and right action. We pray that you will grow each day in compassion for the needy, in concern for the stranger, in love of all people.
May the one who blessed our ancestors, Abraham, Sarah, Isaac, and Rebecca, Jacob and Rachel, and Leah, bless you on your becoming a bat mitzvah. May you grow with strength and courage, with vision and sensitivity, and may you always be certain of our love. Amen. Amen.
And you're going to pinch the sides and turn to the front.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lehitatef bat tzitzi.
Amen.
And now we're going to join together in the blessing of the Shehekianu to bless this new moment, the first time officially that Sophie wears her talit and leads us in prayer. If you know the prayer, you are welcome to join us. Baruch.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam.
Shehekianu.
Shehekianu v'kimanu v'higianu lazman hazeh.
One more time.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Shehekianu v'kimanu v'higianu Lazman hazeh. Ah, 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 amen.
Those words mean, blessed are you, Lord our God, ruler of the universe, who gives us life, who sustains us, and who brings us to this very special moment. So you can give your parents hugs, and they're going to go sit down, and then Sophie and Gabby are going to lead us in prayer. You do need to get a prayer book out if you haven't already. It's the smaller of the two books below you. It should say Mishkan Tefillah, and Sophie's going to tell you what page to turn to.
Our service continues responsively with the Ashrei on page 338.
Ashrei
Yoshvei Beitecha, Oye Hallelujah Selah.
Ashrei
Ha'am Shekachalo, Ashrei Ha'am Shadonai Elohav.
Tehillah LeDavid, Aronimcha Elohai HaMelech, Bavarcha Shimcha Leolam Vaed.
Bechol Yom Avarcheka, Va'ala Shimcha Leolam Vaed.
Gadol Adonai Umehulal Meod, Beligdulato Ein Heker.
Dor Lador Yishabach Ma'asecha, Ugvurotecha Yagidu.
Hadar Kevod Odecha, Medivrei Niflotecha Asicha.
Ve'ezuz Norotecha Yomeru, Ugdach Lach Asaprena.
Zecher Rabatukha Yaviyu, Betzitkatka Yedanenu.
Chanun v'rachum Adonai, Erech Abay Mugdol Chased.
Tov Adonai lakol, v'rachamav al kol ma'asav.
Yoducha Adonai kol ma'asecha, v'chasidecha yivarchucha.
Kevod malchutecha yomeru, ugdulatecha yedaberu.
Lehodia livnei ha'adam gevurotahav, וכבוד הדר מלכותו.
מלכותך מלכות כל עולמים, וממשלתך בכל דור ודור.
סומך אדוני לכל הנופלים, וזוקף הכפופים.
עיני כל אליך יסברו, ואתה נותן לכם את אוכלם בעיתו.
פותח את ידיך, ומסביר לכל חי רצון.
Tzadik Adonai bechol derachav, bechasid bechol masav.
Karov Adonai lechol korav, lechol asher yigra'uhu ve'emet.
Retzon yereav yaseh, be'et shavata mishma ve'yoshiem.
Shomer et Adonai ahav, ve'et kol harshayim yashmid.
Tehilat Adonai yedaber pihi, vivarech kol basar, shem kodsho leolam ba'ed.
Va'anachnu nevarech ya, me'ata ve'ad olam.
Our prayer service continues with the Amidah, and this is a prayer that we all join together with Sophie in. And so at this time, I'd like to invite her friends, if you're studying to become Bar Bat Mitzvah, or if you've recently become Bar Bat Mitzvah, or basically if you know this prayer and you want to come join Sophie, we would love for you to come join her. You can bring your books and come join Sophie up here to lead the prayer together. It shows it's a way of showing her support. Come on. Thank you. And we're all going to rise together and join in this prayer, page 344.
Adonai sefatai titrach ufi yagite hilatecha. Adonai, open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu velohei avoteinu v'imoteinu. Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak, velohei Yaakov. Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, Elohei Leah. Ha'el ha'gadol ha'gibor v'hanara, El Elyon, Gomel chasadim tovim, v'konei ha'kol, v'zomer chasei avod v'imahod, u'mevi geula l'ibnei b'neihem, l'ma'an shemo v'ahava. Melech Ozer, Moshiach Umagen, Baruch Atah Adonai, Magen Avraham, Ve'ezrat Sarah, Atah Gibor Leolam Adonai, Mechaye HaKol Atah, Rav Lehoshiach, Mashiv HaRuach Umorid HaGashem, Mechalkel Chayim Bechesed, Mechaye ha'kol berachamim rabim, Somech noflim verofech holim, Umatir asurim, Umekayem emunato, Lishenei afar, Michamocha ba'al gevurot, Umidom elach, Melech meimid umechaye umatzmiach Yeshua v'ne'eman atah l'chayot ha'kol Baruch atah Adonai mechaye ha'kol. Please remain standing for the Kiddusha, and we call forward to open the Ark on this first Ark opening, Howard and Merle Kosowski, Stephen Kosowski, Sherilyn Jones, Mia Kosowski, David Kosowski, and Sun Young Park. Please come forward to open the Ark. Shimcha ba'olam Keshem shemakdishim Oto bishmei maram Kakatuv aliyah Nevi'ech
Moshiyenu vehu yashmiyenu berachamav lehenei kol chai. Ani Adonai Eloheichem, imloch Adonai leolam, Elohai yechzion ledor vador. Dorva donagid God lecha ulanetzach netzachim kedushat hanahadish veshivchacha Eloheinu mipinu lo yamush leolam vaed baruch ata Adonai ha'el ha'kai.
Please be seated. We continue with a reading on page 353. I'll read it with you. Okay. You read it in that mic. I'll read it in this mic. Okay. One, two, three. For the good in us, which calls us to a better life, we give thanks. For the strength to improve the world with our hearts and hands, we give praise. For the peace in us, which leads us to work for peace, we are grateful. For the gift of Shabbat, which renews us for life, we offer blessing. Baruch Ata Adonai, Mikdash HaShabbat. And at this time, I'm going to invite you to sit down for a few minutes, Sophie, and we're going to continue with the Kaddishenu, which is on the next page. It's in the paragraph, if you'd like to follow along. It's on page 352, a few lines up. It's about the second line in the bottom paragraph.
I'm gonna make it easy.
It's right kind of in the middle, but really what we want you to sing is Lila, Lila, Lila for the most part, if you don't know the words.
I'm gonna make it easy. Eloheinu v'Elohei avoteinu v'imoteinu, ritzeh v'imnuchateinu.
This is a moment for joy. We bring the joy that we feel into this prayer and into this sanctuary. So really, if you don't know the words, it's okay. Just hum along, sing along, sway along, but we want you to be a part of it.
This is your second chance.
The Sabbath Heinu, Lekadesh HaShabbat.
Beautiful. That prayer really is about the holiness of Shabbat, that these are holy moments that we're here together. They're also filled with joy. So take those tambourines if you have them, put them below your seat so you won't kick them or mess with them for the next little while, but we'll take them out again later, not to worry. And at this moment, I would like to invite forward Franco, Luca, Maria Antoinetta, and Alex Montoro to lead us in the prayer on page 355. You've got it. There, on this holy Shabbat.
On this holy Shabbat, may we draw nearer to life, peace, and joy. May we find true rest, holiness in our deeds.
No, he's going to read it.
Worth in our study of Torah, let us feed on the love of Godness. Let us drink from the love of Godness. Restrain our thirst for excess and cleanse our hearts to serve life well. On this holy Shabbat, may we draw nearer to life in peace and in joy.
Great job. Thank you so much. We say, Baruch atah Adonai she'orcha levarcha b'yirah na'avod. Beautiful. Thank you. So Shabbat is a time for giving thanks for all of our many blessings. And it's especially evident when the family comes together and friends come together and we're here for such a special occasion. And for Sophie having reached this moment in her life that we really think about what we're thankful for. So I want to invite you to share with the community what it is that you're thankful for at this time. So if you have something on your mind, raise your hand, I'll come to you, and we really want to hear from you. What are you thankful for today? So tell us, here we go.
I am thankful for I am thankful for Sophie Fiddler and Sarah Fiddler and the Fiddler family.
Thank you. That was so lovely. Beautiful. We're thankful for you, Sophie, and Sarah, and the Fiddler family. All right, who else over here? Don't be shy. What are we thankful for? Yeah.
I'm thankful for my family, and I'm thankful for my friends, and yeah.
Thank you. All right, guys, come on.
I'm thankful for the opportunity to be here and support my friends in this important moment in their lives.
Good. What do we think? Come on. I know you guys are not that shy. Anybody? Yeah, maybe? Anybody? No? Nope. Okay, family. Let's see. Yep, I'll pass the microphone down.
I'm thankful for our wonderful family and being all together.
I'm thankful that I get to spend that time with Sophie and Ross and Tilly and the whole family.
Anybody else over here? We have so much to be grateful for, and even if we don't want to share them, that's okay. We do. We have so much to thank God for in our everyday, just the ability to have food and shelter, the very basic things, but also to be able to have education and learning and community, and for the moments of peace that we do have, even when we pray that there will be so much more peace in the world. There's so much that we do have to be grateful for. So we say on Shabbat, and in fact, in Jewish tradition, we say every day,
Thank you, God, for this moment. Thank you, God, for this day. And thank you, God, for this holy Shabbat. And with that, we have a special prayer that was written by actually Sophie and two of our other students, Lael Matfeld and Ella Siegel, which is a blessing for peace that they wrote during their JPLEX religious school time, their BMC, B'nai Mitzvah Club. This is what they wrote. Baruch Ata Adonai, blessed are you, Adonai, our God, who is full of grace and mercy. You have delivered us from slavery, filled our hearts with joy, and brought us to this moment. We pray for a life of peace and happiness for all of Israel and the whole world. We hope that through your loving care, people will learn to sort out their differences and make efforts to build a world of shalom. Through your blessing, we pray to have successful friendships, lifelong relationships to you, our Creator, and that the earth and its oceans become healed and restored. Thank you, God, for your blessing of abundant peace. And we say, Amen. We take this time for our own silent thoughts and prayers. Gabby and Cantor Siegel and Jenny for beautiful music. And Gabby also is our B'nai Mitzvah director, who not only has been working with Sophie, but all of our B'nai Mitzvah students, and leading our B'nai Mitzvah club so beautifully and with so much strength and creativity and love and devotion. Gabby, it's just wonderful what you have really helped us create along with Seth and Guy and our whole education department. It's really, really special. Thank you. Thank you, Gabby. It is now time for our Torah service, our Seder Kriyat HaTorah on this Shabbat afternoon. So turn to page 362 and 363 in your books, and we call forward to open the Ark this second time. Phil and Laura Fiddler, Evan, Barbara, Jacqueline, Carolyn, Lauren, Ryan, Ryder, Kennedy, Lane, and Lisa Phillips, all go ahead,
Please go on up to the ark. You can go ahead and open the ark. Assemble the people, men, women, and children, and the strangers in your cities to hear, to learn, to revere Adonai your God, to observe faithfully the words of this Torah, and let their children who do not yet know it hear that they too may learn to revere Adonai your God. Please rise.
Ein kamocha va Elohim Adonai ve'ein kema'asecha malchutecha malchut kol amim u'memshaltecha bechol dor v'ador Adonai melech Adonai malach Adonai imloch le'olam avad Adonai oz le'amo yitein Adonai yevarech et amo v'shalom av harachamim heti Shato Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad Echad Eloheinu Gadol Adoneinu Kahato Lula Donahaiti, Unaromema, Shemo Yahdav.
At this holy moment, we hold our Torah, take it from the ark. And just as these stories were passed down through the generations of our people, today they will be passed through the Jewish generations of her family to Sophie as a precious heritage. And so I call forward to stand right in front of the Bima to pass the Torah, Phil and Laura Fidler, Howard and Merle Kosowski, Ross and Matilda, and Sophie. As we pass this sacred scroll to Sophie, we pray that she will hold it close to her heart, not only today, for her whole life, and that it will continue to guide her with all of its values.
We are gifts and we are blessing. We are history in song. We are hope and we are healing. We are learning to be strong. The door of a door, Nagid Mod Lecha. The door of a door. Door by door, these lips will
Shabbat Shalom. My Torah portion is called Vayikra, and it is the first one in the book of Leviticus. It takes place in the Sinai Desert in the tabernacle, which is like a portable sanctuary in the middle of the Israelite camp. God gives the people instructions about how the Israelites can create a personal relationship with God and also a communal relationship with God. The instructions include giving gifts like meat and other animal parts, as well as grain and other foods to God as a way to connect to God. Many of the animal parts are to be eaten by the priests. My parasha describes five different types of offerings. They are to establish and maintain God's nearness to the people of Israel. Olah, or the burnt offering, Milha, or meal offering, Zevach Shelamim, sacrifice of well-being, Shetat, sin offering, and the Hasham offerings, reparation offering. The manner the sacrifice is made is described in detail. The first three offerings are voluntary, but the last two types are necessary for worshipers to clear their name. In today's world, we no longer have a sacrificial system. We do not bring animals to sacrifice to show our appreciation for God or even to use to repent for wrongdoing. People pray to God instead of offering animal sacrifices to God in modern times. I can connect this to my life because I pray to God. When I pray, I feel connected to Adonai and my community. After the temple was destroyed, the rabbis determined that since sacrifices were only offered at the Jerusalem temple, the people would have to wait until a third temple was built to make sacrifices, which seemed unlikely. Already at that time, the rabbis had introduced in the 3rd century BCE the idea of saying particular prayers in place of those same sacrifices. In different prayers for different purposes and times, this is still the case today. Just like the purpose of the sacrifices was to clear your name, repent for sin, or to get closer to God, that too is the case with prayer. My question is, why did the Israelites feel their connection to God through animal sacrifices? Rabbi Siegel and I talked about this, and even though she is a vegetarian and I eat meat, we both agree that a barbecue filled with meat smells pretty good and creates a lot of smoke. This could be what the people thought that God would enjoy. It is easy for us to imagine God being happy with that situation. They might have thought that was an act of love for God because it smelled so good to them, so they could believe that God might be more forgiving if God was enjoying that yummy smelling meat. What is prayer? I think prayer is like talking to God and reflecting on things you have done, asking for forgiveness, and thanking God for everything God has done for you or your family. As I become a bat mitzvah, I think my connection to God may become stronger. Also, now that I am an adult in the Jewish faith, I know that my prayers and my spiritual life are my responsibility. My mitzvah project is raising money for the American Jewish Joint Distribution Committee. It is an organization that is helping Jews in Israel during the war right now, ensuring the provision of pre-war services, economic relief for Israelis in distress, and small business owners and more. Historically, it is an organization that helped Jews in distress around the world and helped many Jews come to America. To raise money for this important cause, I sold donuts at Temple, and I'm educating my family and friends about the JDC. Now that I am a Jewish adult, I look forward to coming to JPLEX on Sundays, Monday night BMC, Shabbat, and holiday services. I also really want to go to Israel someday.
I'm so happy that Sophie was able to give that speech, and I hope you could hear it. I could, and I'm really so thrilled that you could do that, Sophie, because she really worked hard on her beautiful introduction to her Torah portion. And it's a hard Torah portion, actually. We'll talk more about it in a moment. And you did a beautiful job explaining it and teaching us about it. And now we're going to, Sophie's going to be chanting from the Torah, and we are going to call up
a number of family members to say the blessings. When I call you up, if you will come up on this side. And I also would love for you to follow along in her Torah reading. So if you find the other book below your seat, you can switch out your books and get the Torah out and turn to page 660. It's the very beginning of Parashat Vayikra. It's a whole new book of the Torah, the third book, the book of Leviticus. And so there's a nice space right here where you can see the beginning of your Torah portion, page 660 in your Chumash, your Torah. And we call forward for the first blessing. Sister Sarah Fiddler. Ta'amod Sarah bat Reuven le'aliyah le'Torah Rishona.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach le'olam va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach le'olam va'ed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bahar Banu Mikol Ha'amim Venatan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen. Vayikra El Moshe Vaydaber Adonai Elav Me'ohel Moed Lemor Daber El Venei Israel Vemata Alehem Adam Kiakriv Mikem Korban Ladonai Mina Beheman Mina Wakar Umina Zon Dakribu E Korban Hem Im Olam Korbano Mina Wakar Zahar tamim yakrivenu el petach ohel moed yakriv oto litzono livnei Adonai.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lanu Torat Emet Behaye Olam Nata Betohenu Baruch Ata Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen. And for the second Aliyah, we call forward proud parents Ross and Matilda. Ta'am tu Reuven Baruch ben Fishela Aliyah le Torah Shenit.
Hold on, Ross. You should take your talit, those fringes, and attach them to the Torah.
I have to mention that Ross is wearing the talit from his bar mitzvah just a few short years ago.
Very stylish. Baruch Adonai Hamvarach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bakar Banu Mikol Ha'amim V'Na'atan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
Besamach Yado Al Rosh Haola Benitza lo lehaper alav Beshahat et ben hawakar livnei Adonai Beikrivu benei Aharon Akohanim e Adam Besarku e Adam Alamitzvea Sabib Asher Petach Ohel Moed Vehivshit et ha'ola Venitachota Lintaheha.
Baruch Aruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu Torah emet, v'chaye olam nata betokeinu, Baruch ata Adonai, notein ha-Torah.
Amen. Give her a big hug, mazel tov, and you can stand.
And for our third and final aliyah, we call forward our bat mitzvah herself, Sophie Fiddler. Ta'amod, ta'amod, ha-bat mitzvah, Milka bat Reuven l'aliyah le-Torah hizki.
Baruch atah Adonai Elohim. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach.
Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Asher Bahar Banu Mikol Amim Ve'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch atah Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
Ve'natnu Benei Aharon Hakohen Esh Ala Mitzveah Be'arhu Etzim Ala Esh Be'arhu Benei Aharon Hakohanim Et Anetahim Arosh Bet HaPadet Al ha'etzim asher al ha'esh asher al ha'mitveh bekirvo uchrav irhatz b'mayim behiktir ha'kohen et ha'kol ha'mitveh ha'ola yisher re'ach mihoach
la'adonai.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher natan lanu Torah emet V'hayehe olam nata betoheinu Baruch atah Adonai notein haTorah.
Amen. Okay, I want to be the first one to say it. Mazel tov! Mazel tov! Mazel tov! Oh my gosh.
Mom and Dad, you can go sit down for a few minutes, but I think we're all so proud of you, Sophie. You're amazing. You really are. You worked so hard to not only learn all of your prayers and do everything you needed to do for today, but also then when your voice went away, you still persevered and you still were able to do what you needed to do, which was chant the Torah and give your speech and teach us about your Torah portion. And I have to say, it's really not just about today. It's really about who you are. And you are a bat mitzvah, as you said. You are now an adult in the eyes of the Jewish community. And look around. All these people here are not only witnesses to today, but also really, I don't know if you knew this, I think you did, but by being here, you're also really saying that you are here to support Sophie, not only today, but going forward. And it's really special to be a part of a sacred community like that. And you and your family have made this a priority, to be a part of a sacred community. And I'm so glad that you have, that you've all done that. And again, it's really not just about today, it's really about who you and your family are and coming to this synagogue and making this your second home. I loved seeing you out there selling donuts with your mom on Sundays and raising money for the Joint Distribution Committee, which is really an important organization and always has been. I love that you chose that. That's not something that a lot of students have done, and it's a really important organization that helps people not only today, but has for many, many generations. And you spoke in your Torah portion, in your introduction to your Torah portion, and read from the Torah, really about prayer. And you took a Torah portion that's quite difficult because it's about the animal sacrifices, which we don't even have anymore, but you made it very relatable. into your life, about your prayer life, and the way that you're able to connect to God. And I hope, it is my hope and really my challenge to you, Sophie, that you continue to do that, to feel that, and also when it's a struggle, to struggle with that too, to know that God's presence can be with you when you need God's presence to be with you, and that when you say your prayers, you really can feel them. Not everybody has that. I also share that with you, and I think it's something that's really important and special and helps us in times that are difficult and also in times that are joyous. It's why we say prayers, prayers of joy, to recognize these really happy moments and also to ask God's strength when we have really tough times in our lives. And so that's my challenge to you, Sophie. Keep going. Keep praying. Keep really keeping those words that you learn, the words of prayer, in your heart and a part of your life. And I know that you're going to continue to lead our community in the beautiful ways you've already started to do. And we all, as a community, can't wait to see you go forward and do that as you continue. It is such a blessing to be with you, and Mazel Tov to you and your family. And now it is an honor to call forward your mom and dad, who have a few words of wisdom to share with you.
Hi, everyone. Well, just before we get going, I wanted to welcome everybody and thank you guys for coming. I'm sorry. So before we get going, I want to welcome everyone for coming to support Sophia. She becomes a bat mitzvah today. But before we get started, I wanted to mention that today is our 16th wedding anniversary. So love you. Love you, honey. So happy 16th. Some days it feels like 2 years and some 26, but you know, who's counting? So Sophie, we are so proud of you. You have dedicated countless hours in preparation for today. Let's talk about your name for a minute. The name Sophie means wisdom, the pinnacle of intelligence, knowledge, and experience. Sophie, as a bat mitzvah, you're entering a period of increased responsibility. You are not alone though. You've been part of a Jewish community that has helped you get to this point. Later this year will mark 40 years since I had my bar mitzvah right here in this synagogue. And many of our family and friends that were here in 1984 are sitting here today. So thank you all. A few of your uncles, Stephen, David, and Michael, had their bar mitzvah here as well. And of course, your sister, Sarah. The same community will continue to serve as your foundation as you enter this period of young adulthood. You will have the opportunity to make more of your own decisions. I trust in your wisdom, your intelligence to make positive choices, and the knowledge to learn from your mistakes. These experiences will guide you on the long journey ahead, and I'm so excited for you, excited to watch you grow and become everything that you want to be. So I love you, Angel.
Shabbat Shalom. First, I would like to thank Rabbi Siegel, Rabbi Fish, Daphne Parker, Miss Mickey, Gabby, and the JPLAC team for always making my family feel included, supported, and loved. Thank you so much for the integral role you play in my family. Sophie, my princess daughter. When I was pregnant with you, Daddy and I went to the doctor to find out if we were having a boy or a girl. We were thrilled to learn that we were having our second daughter. The first thing Daddy said when the nurse told us you were a girl was, "Oh no, now I have to pay for two weddings." Poor Daddy. What he really should have said was, "Oh no, now I have to pay for two bat mitzvahs and two weddings." The reason Daddy and I have invested so much time and effort into celebrating you on this monumental day is to teach you a lesson that I was so blessed
that my mother, your grandmama, taught me. Your belief in God, the importance of faith, the power of prayer are the pillars that will constantly be with you in the good times and hard times. Sophie, one of your best qualities is that you have always known what you like and don't like, and you have confidence in your choices. My prayer for you going forward is that you maintain that same confidence and conviction in your belief in God. What does conviction mean? What does it feel like? It should feel like this moment as you stand here wearing your Jewish star in front of our community, proud to be a Jewish young woman with your heart filled with God's peace and happiness. Remember this feeling as you go out in the world where being a Jewish woman isn't always easy. Another one of your beautiful qualities is your sense of humor, which reminds me a lot of my father, your grandpapa. Grandpapa also loved enjoying life in the moment. So many friends gravitate to you because of your ability to be present. God wants us to enjoy the precious present. Today is your day. All of your family and friends have come here at this moment to congratulate you on all of your years of hard work and commitment to religious schooling. It is almost time to party. My daughter, you are affectionate, gentle, nurturing, and loyal. These wonderful qualities make you such a love to all of those that you choose to allow near. You are a loving leader to your baby cousin, Amelia. You're an excellent caretaker of Jian's doggies, Pavi and Piana. And like your grandmother Noni says, Sophie is such a delicious love. I'm so lucky that God blessed me with you as my daughter. I love you the most. God bless you, my princess Mazel Tov.
I would like to invite forward Cantor Siegel. We're going to offer a blessing for you all. For you, Sophie, and your parents, after those beautiful words of blessing. These are the oldest, most ancient words from our tradition, and you are the inheritor of many beautiful traditions on both sides of your family. And with those blessings, we offer you, and in these words, we offer you all the blessings of our people.
Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha.
May God bless you and keep you.
Yair Adonai panav elecha v'yichunecha.
May God's face shine upon you and may God deal graciously with you.
Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha. Shalom, shalom.
May God's presence always be with you, Sophie, and may it bring you a life of health, of happiness, of family, of friends, of learning, of leadership, and the greatest gift of peace. And we all say amen and mazel tov.
Yeah.
Good job with the tambourines. That's right. It's time to celebrate. We are going to put the Torah away and conclude our service and have a few more blessings, and then it will be ready to, it'll be time to celebrate. So we call forward Ross, who's going to lift the Torah, and Sarah, who's going to put the Torah away, to dress the Torah, as we please, will I ask everyone to please rise as we lift the Torah for Hagba.
V'zot ha-Torah asher sam Moshe lifnei b'nei Yisrael al-pi Adonai b'yad Moshe. Yai lai 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 lai.
Please be seated.
Sophie, it is my turn to say some words to you.
We can't hear you.
Now you cannot hear me?
I think.
Let me see now. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Sophie, I have so much to tell you, but I want to make it short because I know you want to go party and you deserve it. I am super proud of you. I know how hard you worked. You knew every single prayer very well. You impressed me at every single lesson. Every time we met on FaceTime and every time I see you here on Mondays, you're always here and ready to learn, to have fun, to make friends, to be a great student, to learn and to teach. And I have to tell you that it's not just me, but every single teacher from the education of Temple Judea since you came to our preschool and religious school, everybody's proud of you and everybody loves teaching you. So my challenge to you is to continue being who you are. Now you're gonna be a Jewish adult, and I cannot wait to see what the future holds for you. And I'm welcoming you to teach with me. And I'm excited, I heard on your speech that you said you're gonna continue coming on Monday nights to BMC, right? Did I hear right? Yes? So you're gonna teach now. Now you're gonna be a teacher. So I'm super excited for that. And I have to tell you that I love you since I met you. You were like maybe 2 years old because Sarah and my youngest son were in preschool together and your mom and I became very good friends as soon as we met. And I've always loved watching you grow. So I cannot wait to see all the things that are coming for you. I love you. I'm very proud of you.
Okay, this is the fun part. I get to give you a lot of gifts. Sophie, you ready? A lot. Really, I'm serious. Okay, on behalf of the Board of Temple Judea, I am proud to present you with several gifts recognizing this important milestone. Here we go. First, you get this book on the doorpost of your house. It has all the blessings in it that you will need going forward in your life. Of course, you still have us always at Temple Judea, but this is for things like when you go and have your first home that you want to put the mezuzah up on the door, you can do it. It has the blessings in it for that and many other special occasions. On behalf of the Jewish Museum of Florida, FIU on Miami Beach, I'm proud to present to you, through the generous support of the Jonathan Simons B'nai Mitzvah Project, a certificate for a one-year family gift membership to the museum. And I really hope that you and your family will go. I just went recently, and it is fabulous. They have all kinds of beautiful exhibits about the history of Jews here in Florida, and then they have all kinds of special exhibits as well. So that's for you. And then we encourage you to travel to Israel, you know, because you heard about it last night, that I've have been to Israel many times, and we have a strong connection to Israel as Jews, and we want you to go, and I know you want to go, so here are two different ways that you can go to Israel. And I was actually just with the person who heads up this program. It's called Yala Israel, and this is $3,200, $3,250 towards a URJ Yala Israel trip. And those are really special trips. I have one child who's been on this trip, and then the other gift certificate that we're giving you is towards the Alexander Musk High School in Israel. I have a son who went on that one last 2 years ago. It's a wonderful program. That program was started by the former rabbi here at Temple Judea, Rabbi Morris Kipper, Zichrono Livracha, may his memory be a blessing. He left from Temple Judea and went to start that program, the High School in Israel program, many years ago, and it's really thriving. It's an amazing program. So I hope you'll go on that or consider it. And the pen that we signed your certificate with, first the certificate that we signed in my study just now, as well as the pen that we used to sign it, it says on it, the more Torah, the more life. Marbe Torah, marbe chayim. Those are words from the Talmud, because the more Torah you bring into your life, the fuller your life will be. And it also says on here, Temple Judea, your second home here away from home, as it has been since you were really little. And so here are some of those gifts. And then there's more. You really are getting a lot of gifts. Here's the last gift is, this is going to be a new leaf on our Simcha tree here at Temple Judea, out in the hallway. It says, in honor of our daughters, Sarah and Sophie Fiddler. Sarah, you got in there too. And it says, we love you, Ross and Matilda Fiddler. So you'll have to come visit your leaf on the Simcha tree. I'm gonna keep that so we can put it up. These are all for you. You can take them and go sit down for about 30 seconds. Enjoy. Enjoy that rest. And while she sits down, we're going to get ready to conclude our service. So if you have your Torah book out, you can put it back away and take out your siddur. And we are going to call forward to bring the Torah, to open the ark, and I'll bring the Torah back to the ark. We invite forward for this ark opening, Ross, Matilda, and Sarah Fiddler, Sebastian and Maria Castro, Matthew and Matias Castro. Please rise.
Yahalelu et Shem Adonai, ki nisgav shemo levado, hodol al eretz v'shamayim v'yare. Shabeach ladon hakol latet gedula liotzeh breshit shelo asanu kigo yeharatzot velo samanu kemishpachot adama shelo samchel keinu kahem vegor aleinu kechol hamonam va'anachnu korim u'meshach Lifnei melech, machei hamlachim, hakadosh, Baruch Hu, V'nehemar, V'haya Adonai, L'melech al kol haaretz, B'yom ha'hu, B'yom ha'hu, Yiyeh Adonai echad, U'shemo, U'shemo, U'shemo,
It is especially at these moments of togetherness and joy and simcha that we also remember those loved ones who are not here, those loved ones who came before us, those who we keep in our hearts and in our memories, and whose values continue to be a part of our lives. The way that they lived helped us or taught us the way to live. And as we remember them in this special moment, we say their names as a lasting memory. And as we think of them, we pray that their memories will always, always be a blessing. Today, we especially think of and remember Selma Kupferberg, Sammy Fiddler, Irving Bing and Joyce Kossoff, Frida Kosowski, Matilda Velez Castro, Fernando Castro, Johns Turner Castro, Robert Turner, Rebecca Castro, Jacob Kosowski, Beatrice Castro Gomez, Constance Kosowski, and John Doyle. We say Zichronam Livracha, may all of their memories forever be a blessing. As we join together on page 598 in the words of the Mourner's Kaddish. Together, Yitzkadal v'yitzkadash shemei rabah, ve'alma divarach yirutei v'yam lich malchutei, v'chayachon v'yom echon v'chaye d'kol Beit Yisrael, v'agala v'izman kari v'imru, amen. Yehe shemei rabah mevarach le'alam alamei almaya, yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yipa'ar v'yiromam v'yitnase, V'yitadar v'yitalev v'yitalel shemei dukurisha brichu. Leila minko birchata v'shirata, tush bechata v'nechemata, dami rambe alma v'imru, amen. Yehei shalama rabba min shemaya v'chayim, aleinu v'yol kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Ose shalom v'imramav, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu v'yol kol Yisrael v'imru, amen.
Oh, say shalom bimromav, hu yase shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'imru, imru, amen. Yase shalom, yase shalom, shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, yase shalom, yase shalom.
Sophie has a closing blessing for us.
Dear God, thank you for all the people in my family and community who have helped me get to this day. I want to thank, first, Mom and Dad, for everything you both have done for me. You are the best parents I could ever wish for. Thank you for taking me to services at Temple so I can learn about Jewish traditions. I love you both so much. Sarah, you are the best sister ever, and I love you so much. Noni and Pa, I love spending time with you both and making memories while skiing together in Utah. Granny and Poppy, I love our memories in Massachusetts and spending time with you both at dinner in Miami. Rabbi Siegel and Rabbi Fish, for teaching me so much about what it means to be a Jew and making my years at Temple so memorable. Cantor Siegel and Jenny, for singing and playing such beautiful music for our Temple. Last but not least, Gabby, for getting me ready for my special day. I wouldn't be able to do this without you. Amen. Shavuot Tov.
Those last words, that was beautiful, Sophie. Those last words, Shavuot Tov, mean a good week because Shabbat is now ending, or we're getting there. We're getting close to ending, so we're going to make it a little darker in here. We're going to have a little ceremony to close, to really end Shabbat, because we divide between Shabbat and the rest of the week. So
What we're going to do is we're going to make it a little dark in here. We're going to have Havdalah, which are just a few blessings to end Shabbat. So just like we began Shabbat last night together with blessing the candles, the wine, and the challah, now we're going to bless the twisted candle, the wine, and the spices. And we'll pass the spices around. Those spices are supposed to comfort us as we say goodbye to Shabbat. And some people like to hold their hand up to kind of bring a little bit of the light from the candle into the next week, the light of Shabbat into the next week. And the sweetness of the wine reminds us of the sweetness of this moment. So please come close, family. First, come right here in front of the Bima, and we're going to make it a little bit dark, and we're going to sing a psalm to begin Havdalah.
Yai lai la 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 la.
For the separation between Shabbat and the rest of the week. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam ha-mavdil ben kodesh l'chol, ben or l'choshech, ben Yisrael le'amim, ben yom ha-shvi'i, l'sheshet yemei ha-ma'aseh. Baruch ata Adonai ha-mavdil ben kodesh l'chol.
Ha-mavdil ben kodesh, ben kodesh l'chol, chatotinu hu yimchol, zareinu v'chasbeinu yarbech ha-chol.
Vehakochavim alayla. You wish each other Shavua Tov. You can put your arms Shavua around each other if you like, and wish Shavua each other a happy Tov. Week. Shavua Tov.
Shavua Tov.
Shavua Tov.
A good week, a week of peace. May gladness reign and joy increase. Eliyahu Hanavi. Eliyahu HaTishbi, Eliyahu
In those words, we sing about Elijah the prophet, and we pray that there will be a time just like this ahead, a time of peace, of happiness, of that joy that we feel, the warmth that we feel, and we pray that that time will come soon. And with that, we end our service, conclude our service, and say one more time a huge, loud mazel tov for Sophie, mazel tov, Shavuot Tov.
Shalom, 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 aleichem.